Hey, what's up everyone? It's Mr. Duel here again with another Genshin Impact video. In this video, I'm going to be going all over all the bows and their respective roles and helping you choose what kind of role do you want to play for Ganyu. So here, let us begin with the first two, of course, probably the easiest one for most either new players or free-to-play players to get. The first bow, the one that I use currently on Ganyu, is going to be the Prototype Crescent. The reason for this bow is I feel like it's relatively easy to hit characters on their weak spots. Majority of characters have this. I think the only people who don't have it is the Hypostasis and the Slimes. Those are the only two that I could think of at the moment. There may be more. Leave a comment below if there's any others. I feel like this is a very, very good bow for her, honestly, compared to the compound bow. The thing about the compound bow is it's going to be building her for more of an auto attack role, more like physical damage. So you're going to have to get like a physical damage goblet and kind of build around that to really get her going. This could be really strong still. So if anybody's going to be testing that out, that would be kind of cool. But I'm not going to personally go this route just because I want to use her charge attacks, because that's kind of what her role is. Her kit is based around really is that really awesome charge attack and the bloom effect that comes out of it. So the prototype is definitely the one that I'm going to be refining and getting here in the future for her. There is other bows though that you may want to choose. Maybe if you don't want any of those two. The other ones, of course, is the Stringless. The Stringless is going to be a really good bow for elemental reaction. So if you have a melt comp with Ganyu, this would be a really good bow for her, because you're going to be doing a lot more melt damage with this bow because of the elemental mastery. And of course, I think this one has higher attack than most of the other bows, but I could be wrong. The effect is also really good. Her burst and her skill does more cryo damage in general, so this does help overall with her ultimate and her skill. So this is a really good bow to use on her, definitely with a melt composition. Next is a Viridescent Hunt. This one, I wouldn't really recommend it in my opinion. The critical rate is really nice for Ganyu. Really for any character, critical rate is probably one of the most important stats in the game. But when it comes down to it, with the Cryo Resident and her first Accession passive, which is after you shoot a fully charged arrow, I can't remember if it's the first or second, but once you do a charge shot, the next one, you'll have a 20% critical rate increase for Ganyu within 5 seconds. And then on top of that, if you use Cryo Resonance, you'll also get a 15% critical rate bonus. It's already a 35% critical rate bonus. Yeah, on top of if you put the Viridescent Hunt, you'll get another 25%, which is a lot, honestly, which would be really good for her. But if you could just get a crit rate artifact instead, I feel like you might not even need to use the Viridescent Hunt, honestly. But if you have the Skyward Harp, the other one, I would probably put the Skyward Harp over any of the 4 stars, honestly. And then, of course, I don't have the Ammo's Bow, so I can't show you. I don't have the other two, so I'm just going to kind of go over them. And the Ammo's Bow, I think, is her best one because it just increases the charge shots as well. I'm pretty sure that I could remember. If somebody could tell me down below, that'd be great. I can't, because I don't have the bows, so I don't really remember. But going back to this, the critical rate, I feel like you don't really need critical rate, and this effect here is all right for Ganyu. It's not the best. It's still nice to pull them together, so it's easier to hit the bloom shot, to be honest. But I probably would use the prototype Crescent over the Viridescent Hunt, just because of the, again, with the cryo resonance and everything. Next one is the Favonius Warbow. This is a really good ultimate spammer, just like Venti. This is just good for spamming her Q, keeping her out, get enough particles to get her Q again, then change her out or keep her on the field, either one. This is definitely weaker than the other bows, so you definitely won't be doing as much damage compared to the other bows, but you'll definitely have your ult a lot faster, and you'll always have that out. And if you have a melt comp going on, you probably could compare to some of the other bows depending on how you build around it on this bow specifically. Next one is another auto attack bow, like the compound bow, Rust. This one I don't like it as much because I want to build around her charge attacks. There's nothing wrong with the bow itself for Ganyu, but building around the charge attack is the primarily thing I like about Ganyu, so this one's already kind of on the bad side for me. But if you're going for auto attack, physical damage, and just overall like attack percent for your E and your Q, your burst, then this is a good bow. Again, this is just like the compound bow, just auto attack, physical damage. This is main DPS. Favonius is support. Viridescent is main DPS. the stringless, it can be main DPS if you're building around a melt comp. If not, then this is kind of like a support as well. The sacrificial bow, this bow is good because of the energy recharge, so this would be good, you know, again, for spamming her ult. But because of the effect that it has, I really don't like it for Ganyu because her E is not that crazy. It's cool. I like it. Don't get me wrong. I like the flower. Maybe there will be better uses for it in the future. Maybe some people will prove me wrong. But I just don't find it as useful to have this, the sacrificial bow on her. That's really what I'm saying. Like, the skill is awesome. But I just don't feel like you really need the sacrificial bow on her to keep getting this. Plus, it's every 22 seconds. So, like, I really feel like this is not the bow for her, honestly. And if I'm going to rate these bows that I have here at the moment, I would probably pick the prototype Crescent above the rest of them. Then, if I were going to choose the next one, it would either be Stringless or the Favonius War Bow. These two. Then, I'll probably go with the Viridescent Hunt. And then, lastly, I'll probably go Sacrificial and then Rust. My personal preference of the bows. If you do have 5 stars, of course, then it would be the Ammo's Bow over the Skyward Harp, honestly. But again, this is all based on your builds. Again, this is my opinion as well, but, you know, choose the bow that you feel right around your team composition and build and you feel, you know, most comfortable with. And but other than that, guys, if you stayed this long watching the video, I really appreciate it. And if you did like the video, just remember to leave a like and subscribe, and you have a wonderful rest of your day. Thank you again for watching. Unfun-